This is our new storm shelter. This is an Oz above ground shelter. Give you a little tour of it. They say that this weighs 80,000 pounds. Now, I'm 6'3", and the camera's right at my eyes. That's a good, I would say a good 8 feet tall. Now, here's the inside of it. These walls are, they're pretty thick. You can see how thick that top part is. But my mother feels a lot better for this. I'm still skeptical. We live in a neighborhood where we've almost been hit by two EF5s. Both of them hit less than a mile to our north. The May 3rd, 1999 hit our housing addition to the north less than half a mile. We actually took a little damage at the house. The May 20th, a couple years ago, hit 3/4 of a mile to the south of us, which totally wiped out my uncle's house. Now, what I'm asking you is, do you think this Oz above ground storm shelter can withstand an EF5 that pretty much bulldozes everything in this path? I have seen, when we went walking around, we walked from our house to my uncle's house. That's how close we lived, to help him try to salvage what was left. And you have places where the grass is torn up out of the ground. You know, and even when we went and looked at these in person, me and my mother, you know, the woman, the girl, she was a young girl, talking about, you know, EF5s and all this when they hit, and she's talking about the foundation, and she's like, you know, nothing's left by the foundation. And I remember sitting there thinking to myself, and I was like, yeah, you are exactly right. There is nothing left but the foundation. So I don't know if this would withstand it. I mean, or is it heavy as hell? Yeah, it looks it. I mean, the walls are thick as hell. But will it separate from the foundation? Will it come apart? Will it pull this? Will it tilt it over? I mean, you're talking about tornadoes that aren't EF5s that are picking up freight trains and tossing them and knocking them over. Not tossing them, but knocking them over. I've seen videos. So I don't know. Give me your opinion. You know, here in Oklahoma here lately, the below ground shelters, if it rained, we had one person drowned in her below ground shelter because it filled up with water. And good Lord knows how it happened. I'm not here to bash her, but she couldn't get out for whatever reason. I can't tell you how many cases of the underground shelters floating up that are actually buried in the ground pretty good, actually breaking the concrete, breaking the ground surface, and floating up and out. So, I mean, what the hell do you do? I really don't know. You know, you're not supposed to run. I'm still, I mean, am I happy I got this? You know, EF1, 2, 3, maybe 4. I think this thing will take a beating. But an EF5, one of those dreadful big monsters that we get here in Moore, Oklahoma? Man, I don't know. I don't know if I'm going to get in it or just try to get out of the way of it. But if you don't live here, when there's a big tornado coming around here and you don't have one, it's the traffic is terrible. You couldn't go anywhere if you wanted to. It's just congestion. You're stuck. And I truly feel that one of these times it's going to get bad. But let's go inside here. Come on, Sophia. They tiled the floor. It might get a little echoey in here. I am 6'3". I'm 6'3", and I have just enough room to put the spaces of my fingers in between the head and top of this. So it's about 6'4". I do have to duck to come into the ceiling. They did tile the floor, which is really nice. Nice little bench in here. Can easily hold four people. But here's the door. Let's. I'm going to close this. I don't know if you, see if you can see in here or not. Probably not. But here's that latch. And you see this latch. It goes forward. And then you lift this up. Kind of hard to do with one hand. And then you push. See how the light just disappears? Because it really pulls it towards the... towards it. Oh, man, that's hard to get that done. And then you unlatch it. That's a pretty good door, too, if you want to look at the door. It's about an inch thick. You know, it's not one single piece of steel. It's pretty solid. There's the rails. There's one. A little bit of the covering, but this is it. We just happen to live in Moore, Oklahoma, which is dang near the tornado capital of the world. I know no one's designated that, so please don't leave comments like, well, who the hell said y'all were that? I'm just saying. Moore, Oklahoma gets hit pretty often, and when we do get hit, we get hit with some big ones. I swear two of them. 99, the May 20th one, 2003, I believe it was. Had damn near taken out the whole city of Moore, just those two alone. But yeah, that's it. Leave your comments. If you have one of these and have been in it during a tornado, you know, what was it like? Do you feel comfortable with it? Because honestly, with all the problems that people have been having with in-ground shelters, I mean, what option is there really? I mean, we don't have the room nor the money to put like a dang freight, diesel, those containers that diesels haul completely underground, bury it like a living quarters, like a prepper does. We don't have that money. So the only reason we got this because the area that we live in, they're giving rebates out to people so we can afford these. And an awesome percentage rate off too. But I don't remember how far they put it into the ground. That's my deal. You know, EFI comes through, it takes everything off the foundation. Pretty much the only thing that's left is the foundation. Is this the exception? I just don't know.